Well, you talked to Brandon Reels this morning?
Yeah.
How's he doing?
He's good. He says staying at the gym every day.
And, That's good.
You know, he told me he wants to go to Mars' fight.
Hey, Mars, Reels is coming to your fight.
Oh, yeah.
He's thinking about it.
He's thinking about going to it. He says, I can't promise, but I'm thinking of going to that fight.
I hope the fight's in L.A. or Vegas. If anybody who can make that happen, please make it in L.A. or Vegas.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Because yeah, New York's expensive.
Brandon told me this morning, you know, that he wants to go to that fight. So
that's cool.
Yeah, if he wants to go, I'll be more than happy to invite him and fly him out there. You know, we got our good friend in New York, my friend Jay.
Yeah, he's really cool.
So
I saw him.
We don't have to worry about hotels and stuff like that. He's got like five hotels in New York.
And a restaurant.
And restaurants. He's got a few restaurants too. So we don't have to worry about that. So if Brandon wants to go, I'm more than happy to follow him out there.
I gotta ask you this, Robert.
And he'll be sitting ringside, right?
Yeah, why not?
He'll be sitting ringside.
You have a fight tomorrow.
Yes.
Navarro, right?
Two fighters.
Who's the two fighters?
Look, check this out. We got Jonathan Navarro fighting for his fifth fight. He's 4-0 with 3 knockouts. Tomorrow he's fighting his fifth fight.
Velasco Theater in LA, of course.
Velasco Theater at the Soto Caraz.
Kamagai. I hope Soto wins.
That's going to be a good fight. And then we have Genaro Gomez turning pro.
Wow.
His pro debut from San Diego. So everybody from San Diego, I know it's sold out, so I'm not inviting people to show up. Watch it on Estrella TV because the Genaro fight is going to be televised. It's going to be the opening fight at 7.
Wow.
Right at 7, Genaro Gomez is going on national TV on Estrella TV. So check it out and show support and love for my fighters. You know, it's his pro debut, so there's a lot of questions. You know, a lot in stake. You know, but he's a hell of a amateur fighter, so we should see this fight and see how he does.
By the way, Robert, do you know what's next for Chavez Jr.? Because he's been training at his house.
Yeah,
he invited me to come visit him.
We're actually supposed to meet. We were supposed to meet yesterday, but it didn't happen. So and it won't happen tomorrow because I'm busy with the fights. So we're meeting next week to talk about what's gonna happen. I know he wants to fight in June, so we're gonna plan it out already.
That'd be awesome. Because Badu Jack is fighting Lucien Boutte.
Yes, yes. No, it'll be somebody else. It's another fight. Maybe not a title fight, but whatever it is, it's too big.
He just needs to fight.
He needs to fight. Because it's almost going to be a year.
Wow.
So we have to set up training camp and everything. And now that Mikey's back, you know, we got Amir getting ready for his June fight. And we have Josito started training again too.
Any idea who he's going to fight?
No,
does he fight the winner, Bruto Ortiz?
That'd be nice, man. That'd be nice. Because it'll be 3 months before they fight, and that's the time we need for Josito. We need at least 2 months with Josito. He looks thin. He doesn't look...
He's running a lot. Yeah, I always see him running.
So
he's always running.
He looks thin, but we need to do the
boxing.
You know? He's recovering from his hand. Now it's good. So we got to get him started. And within 2 months, 2.5 months, he'll be ready to fight. So he could fight sometime in June also. And that'll be him, you know. And then of course the rest of my guys, my Russians in Oxnard, you know, they're all looking really good, sensational. So we
Everybody were impressed with Alex Gvozdik, Robert.
Oh my God.
He stole the show that night.
Alex Gvozdik, man.
Kovalev fought the same opponent and stopped him in a longer time.
Stopped him in 3 rounds. Gvozdik put him to sleep. Man.
That guy is 33 wins, 3 losses. That's a legitimate fighter.
Guy. It's a fighter, man.
But nobody knows. Even he dropped Brandon in sparring. Gvozdik is the hardest hitting guy in your gym. He looks innocent. He doesn't look like
he taps, but when he throws, boom, that motherfucker.
You told me you could feel
it. You could feel it. You know, and all these guys are dedicated, you know. And then you got Igis, who fought an 8-rounder, you know, tough guy.
Yeah.
You know, he won a decision, you know. Igis is, he hits so hard.
He does.
And everybody top right thinks, you know, he's the hardest hitter, pound for pound, which I think he is, but this guy was just tough, took everything, but it was good work for Igis, because Igis, you know...
He needed the rounds, all his wins are first round.
Out in 1 or 2 rounds, I think he needed the rounds, and it was an 8-rounder, he looked really good doing it, you know, he made a miss and landed everything he wanted, so that was a really good win for Igis, and a week before, Bisputin looked really good too, he looked sensational, in Oxnard, at the Oxnard show. With our other guy turning pro, Mad Max, we call him. He's also one of the Russians guys.
Skinny kid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He also looked really good. He just signed the top rank and turned pro on the second. So no, we're gonna be really busy, man. We got a lot of fighters, you know. Now with Mikey back, Abner getting ready, Jose back, Chavez. Hopefully we could work out a good deal where we do training camp here in Oxnard. Cause I mean here in Riverside, cause I needed to be here, cause I can't this time around I can't be going back and forth, especially with Abner and Mikey.
Abner's a title fight.
Exactly.
Mikey, it's a lot of pressure, a lot of attention on Mikey. Everything.
No, and Chavez should understand that too. I think when we talk, he should understand that, you know, this is also, they're also my fighters and they're his teammates.
His stable mates.
So they gotta support each other and they gotta help each other out. So that I could arrange the times for everybody to get their own time. I have no problem with that. But I think it has to be here, and that's one thing we have to talk to Chavez about. Hopefully we work something out, and I think he will. He's also a good dude to
he's
talk
a great dude. He's a very nice person. People always criticize him, Robert, but he's one of nicest people you will meet. Forget boxing.
People criticize for, you know, for the negative things that, you know,
that they saw on HBO,
not making weight or training at 2 a.m. and eating cereal, stuff like that. A lot of people do that shit on purpose just so the TV could show. That don't mean he's doing it every night. You know what I mean? It's just the way it is. But he has had a lot of negative things about him. But when you get to know him and you work with him, he's a great person, man. He's got a great heart. He helps everybody out. He doesn't.
He's very generous. He's a very generous person.
Very generous. Takes care of everybody. Always, you know, whatever he thinks about, you know, in boxing, like, what do you think, Robert? You think it's good? You think that? You know, so he's always asking me, what do you think? What do you think? You know, so he listens. You know, people have the wrong
impression
about him because of what they've seen on TV or him not making weight, you know, stuff like that, which I don't blame him. Or him testing positive. I don't blame them. But he's got a great heart. You know, people don't see that. Yeah. Great heart.
There you have Robert Garcia. Make sure to follow him on Instagram at Robert Garcia Boxing Academy and on Twitter at Garcia Boxing. FaceyReporting.com and Melissa Back reporting. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Eli Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram at Eli Sekpak.